Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here today. Don't forget to please subscribe, thumbs up, and share. The Kern River Canyon Fault, drawn out here in Redsman, fairly active. This is a strike-slip fault zone, and these earthquakes all started out probably with this magnitude 4.0 by Bodfish. On the 27th of August this month, which would have been Saturday, 325 people said they felt that earthquake. This area of the fault is moving north. Well, recently, going north towards Lake Isabella, there's been 29 earthquakes in one small location, the largest being a magnitude 3.4. That was on the 28th of this month. Today is the 30th. So first we had the 4.0, which was on Saturday, and then we had the 3.4, which was the next day, which would have been Sunday. So this movement of the Kern Valley Fault System seems to be currently stuck in this location. Yeah, it seems to be all within this one little subdivision. Boy, those poor people. As you know, any earthquake has a 20% chance of being a foreshock for something much larger. But they've been getting smaller since that magnitude 3.4. It was felt as far west as Cambria and as far south as the Los Angeles area. Let's see here. Intensity level 4. Which means it was felt indoors by many people, outdoors by a few. At night, they would have been woken up. Dishes, windows, doors were rattling. Autos rocked noticeably. You probably should check your water and gas lines. Now, this 4.0 on Saturday, USGS actually upgraded it. 325 people said they felt it. The shake map intensity level 5 and 4. It was felt as far south as Oceanside, down there near the border. And let's see, right there, intensity level 5. Which means it was felt by just about everybody, and there was some breakage of dishes. Maybe their windows broke, cracked, plaster cracked, disturbance of tall objects, which means they probably fell over. So you can see how the fault line is moving. Oh, probably northeast a little bit. Here we have the area of Ridgecrest and Wells Valley. Over here is Bakersfield. Let me zoom in a little bit. And then going to the magnitude 3.4, here we got Bakersfield. And you can see how this fault, I hope you can see how it's slowly moving towards the northeast. So going back to the earthquake swarm, let's bring this out. And I tried to draw out the fault line the best that I could. Yeah, this part of the plate is slowly moving northeast. There, I got a little arrow drawn out. And then up over here, this is Ridgecrest, that area. We got the Garlock Fault drawn out in light blue and red. You can see how the Kern River Valley Fault kind of makes a turn. I've covered this other area about the White Wolf Fault, and yeah, they've had some large earthquakes there in the past. In 1952, there was actually a magnitude 7.7. The mountains actually lifted up in the tunnels for the trains and then set it back down on the train tracks that were bent. So looking at some of the moment tensor balls for the swarm of earthquakes that have been happening here, there's tension that has been built up in this area. We got the Coso volcanic field, and we got Ridgecrest. You can see how this fault is moving. Yeah, where's the next earthquake going to be? I'm going to guess and say possibly Ridgecrest in that area. So many of you have felt this 3.4 and the 4.0. What was it like? What did you experience? What damage did you have? I hope you are prepared for a larger earthquake. You should keep prepping. If it's not for an earthquake, you should prep just to try and beat inflation. We have a railroad strike coming, and 3/4, I believe it is, 1/3 of all our goods are transferred by railroad. And the crop failures have been tremendous. We're only getting about 50% of what we should get that will be on the shelves next year. Right now, what we're eating was grown last year, and the drought has killed a lot of crops. Thank you for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Like I said, keep prepping. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.